Hi, my name is Asif Khan and I'm a cloud solution architect at Microsoft. In today's session, we will be discussing about Azure Arc enabled Kubernetes with GitOps Flow. So I already did a session about how you can enable Azure Arc on top of your Kubernetes cluster, which might be running in on-prem or a data center, or maybe other clouds like AWS, Google, or Alibaba, or any other popular cloud. So the session I did earlier, the link for that is already available in the description. You can get and have a check, and you can also implement using the same details which I provided in that session. I did the implementation using Micro K8s, which is a product from the Canonical, the same team who builds the Ubuntu. But in today's session, we will take the next step from there, which is once the Arc, Azure Arc infrastructure is enabled on your Kubernetes cluster, how can you enable GitOps? Now, the interesting fact about GitOps Flow is that once you have enabled Azure Arc or you're running a Kubernetes cluster with Azure Arc enabled, the thing is that next thing is you would like to do some application solutioning and building an application on top of that Kubernetes cluster, and then you would like to centrally manage it using the Azure Arc experience. Now, in a nutshell, what Azure Arc does is it basically projects your Kubernetes cluster, which might be running in any external location, as I told, and that projection basically is directly visible inside your Azure portal experience, just like a native service. So what happens is once you have that native experience, you can do a couple of things, things like you can enable policies, you can have extensions, and one of the most interesting one is about this GitOps. On top of it, you can also do a lot of monitoring stuff and automation as well. But with respect to the GitOps, we are talking about the application lifecycle management, the ALM. So what that means is, and when we say ALM, I think so we already have a lot of models what are already in use. So let's say the most popular one is the DevOps. So you have a application lifecycle management, which you normally manage through your DevOps channel, whichever product you are using for that. Now, the difference between a DevOps experience and a GitOps experience is, let's say most of the organizations in today's scenario, they deal with these application solutioning, and normally they use version control and things like GitHub and GitHub Actions for their release processes and whatnot. Now, the interesting bit about this GitOps Flow with Kubernetes is that it basically helps you in simplifying or maybe making it more comfortable and smooth experience for your application lifecycle. Now, what that means is, in a nutshell, the GitOps Flow basically runs on a couple of tools or a couple of components which gets deployed, and those components just get any update which happens in your GitHub repo, pulls that and deploys a new version for your application inside your infrastructure. So let me quickly walk you through what that means. So if we go inside the basic flow of GitOps with the Azure Arc, the GitOps is not very specific to Azure Arc. GitOps is a industry standard. There are other products as well which are running on top of GitOps. What Azure Arc Kubernetes team did, they used the same model for basically giving a better overall 360 experience. So you take your cluster, you enable Arc, you have the management pane inside Azure. Now, about the application lifecycle, you can use GitOps for that. So in this scenario, as you can see on the left side, we have quite a good numbering, 1, 2, 3, 4. So 1 and 2 is where we are talking about different Kubernetes models. So whether you can have a cloud enabled one from Google or AWS, or you can have a Rancher K3, which is an IoT solution, or you can have your own bare metal Kubernetes cluster. Now, either of those can be projected into Azure using Azure Arc. Now, this is what we have already done in our previous session. In today's session, we will be talking about the GitOps configuration and also how that GitOps work. So what happens is once we have enabled Azure Arc on top of a Kubernetes cluster, we can provide a configuration segment. We have a configuration segment in that Azure Arc enabled projected instance. And in the configuration, we can see we can basically enable a GitOps configuration. Now, what GitOps configuration is, it's more about you provide the details of a private or a public repo, which you might be using for your application. And then you provide a specific deployment file, which can be in current situation, GitOps does support YAML as well as Helm. So either of those models, whichever you are using for the configuration management of your Kubernetes-based applications, they are well supported by GitOps. So what we do is we basically create a GitOps configuration inside the same Azure Arc enable Kubernetes cluster projected instance. And then in that configuration, we provide our GitHub details and all the details around the file, which are our configuration files, which are YAML or Helm. Now, once we have provided those details, this is the component which I was referring to, which basically does all the magic of taking the configuration from your GitHub repos and deploying it into the Azure Arc enabled Kubernetes cluster. Now, this is what is called as Flux. Flux, again, is nothing specific to Azure Arc. It's an industry standard tool model, which is used for any GitOps implementation. So Flux is basically the core for GitOps implementation. Now, what happens is when we enable this GitOps configuration in our cluster, at the same point of time, basically a Flux pod is deployed inside our Kubernetes cluster. And that pod is basically monitoring the specific GitHub details which we have provided in the configuration. Now, what happens is if a user comes in, updates their GitHub repository, the Flux basically has already the details from the configuration file about that repository. It keeps on monitoring. When it finds a change, it pulls the change and then deploys a new version of your application. So it's very similar to a desired state configuration in a conventional infrastructure as a code world. Over here, it's more of an application as a code, application as a configuration. So you have your configuration which comes from the GitHub, and then the Flux agent publishes it to the Kubernetes cluster, which then takes the full control and deploys the new version of the application. So on the portal side, I can quickly show you how that experience looked like. So if you look in the portal, as you can see, this is Azure Arc enabled Kubernetes cluster. I am running a cluster on some Azure VMs. Again, they are bare metal Kubernetes cluster, nothing related to AKS. Now, what I've done is I've just projected that cluster into the Azure Arc ecosystem. And it gives a couple of details, so policies and whatnot, but yeah, I'm using the GitOps. So the GitOps section is over here. It's all blank, and that's the configuration which I was referring to. So I'll show you the GUI experience, but when we will be running the demo, I'll be doing it through a command line. So as you can see over here, what it needs is a couple of details, which is more about what is the scope of your deployment. So you can do a namespace level deployment or a cluster level deployment. Namespace deployment is more preferred because it can help you in then deploying, having multiple configuration for different namespaces, and you can have your application running in their own silos. The other important thing is about the repository URL. So you can provide your GitHub repository URL, which can be a public or a private. And obviously, according to that, you might have to provide the credentials and details how the GitHub's GitOps configuration would be able to access that. So that's in a nutshell about GitOps. Now, I think so we will quickly jump on the demo side of it. So before we do the demo, I'll quickly show you the cluster. So this is the K8 Kubernetes cluster running on my Azure server. And I've just deployed a K9S so that we can have a GUI experience of the cluster. So what you can see over here is I have a couple of namespaces already available. Most of them are Kubernetes native namespaces, but the Azure Arc based namespaces are the ones which are enabled once we have onboarded a new cluster into the Azure Arc ecosystem. So when we onboard the new cluster, we get this Azure Arc namespace, and then there are a couple of different components which get enabled inside that namespace. If you check my previous video, you can see that how these components get deployed when you enable the Azure Arc on top of your Kubernetes cluster. So this is our cluster, and there's nothing fancy. It's a regular cluster. So what we will do today is I'll quickly show you. I have done a custom code, which is more about a simple solution. I have an MVC application. So this is my MVC application running on .NET Core. And if I just run the application, it's a web page, which is a home page, and it just shows an image and some flat text. So in the meanwhile, when it's running, I'll just quickly show you that the image is obviously a static image. As you can see, it's an image over here. but the message is basically coming from a viewBag message. Now that is coming from my environment variable. So I have configured an environment variable, and I'll just quickly show you my controller. So if I go inside the controller, so yeah, the web page is loading, so it's a little bit stuck. Yeah, so as you can see in the controller, I am basically grabbing the environment variable message, and that's the same variable which I am just portraying on the web page. So I've just run the application. If I come inside the web app, eventually it should not take much long. The reason for running this is to just show that, yeah, this is the same application which will be deployed using our deployment model with GitOps. So hopefully it should not, I'm not having a breakpoint. Yeah, that should come quick, hopefully. So in the meanwhile, while it is loading, so what happens is, so this application, basically with this image and the message, I have already created a pod out of it using the Docker file, which is available in the project itself. So if I go back to the project, as you can see, I have a Docker file. Again, a regular .NET Core application deployment Docker file. Nothing fancy in that. What I've done is using the Docker commands, I have just created basically a Docker file, and then I have built that file. That build basically creates an image, and that image I can quickly show you. So if I go into my Docker for desktop, so that's where you can see I have my image in here, and that's the image which gets built, which is getting created when I basically build my Docker file. So coming back to my Visual Studio and the web application. Okay, that's pretty long. Not sure what's happening in the background. But anyways, in the meanwhile, what we can do is we can go into our GitOps.ps, and I'll just quickly show you the configuration which I was referring to. So if I go into my in my whiteboard, sorry. So this GitOps configuration which I was referring to, which has all the details about where exactly is my Git repository, which file it needs to look for, and what are the other details which the particular Flux agent would require to basically deploy the application. All those details are pretty much there in that Git configuration, which is over here in this particular command line. So if I just quickly change, yep. So this command line has all those details. So the Git repository details and whatnot. So as you can see, that those are all variables. So I have Git repository details, my resource group details, my namespace where all this deployment will happen. So I'll quickly run this so that we have all the variables set. And so finally the application is loaded. So this is what the application looks like. It's running from my .NET application on Visual Studio. I'll quickly just stop that so that. All right, so coming back, so that's our simple .NET application. We are not going to do much over here, so I'll just quickly remove it. So all the variables are all set now. Resource group and our cluster, yeah, it's still setting. So once our variable is set, the next what we will do is we will be basically running our git config command. So git config command will basically create a new configuration details inside our Azure portal, inside the Azure Arc enabled Kubernetes cluster, which is projected. So I'll just quickly run the command. So if I run this, so what happens is once the command executes successfully, it will basically give a JSON response about the record getting created in the GitOps segment of the Azure Arc enabled Kubernetes cluster. It normally doesn't take too long. So yeah, I'm expecting it should be pretty quick. Now what happens is once we have our GitOps configuration done, So it should be coming anytime now because so that's our JSON response, which comes from the Azure. And let me just quickly show you on the portal side. So if I get into the portal, I can just refresh this, and then we have a new GitOps configuration. Obviously, it has all the details which are there in this command line. So if you look at it, this is my GitHub Khanasifan Azure Arc GitOps repository, and those are some variables and attributes which we are passing as a parameter. So I'll just quickly show you the command, the K9s, because what's going to happen now is because we have checked in the code, we have basically added a configuration. So that configuration looks for a file in a specific location inside my GitHub repo, and I'll just show you in a while. So as you can see, there are a couple of things which got created. So Azure Arc create hyphen org is a resource group, which is, if you remember, it was the same which was there in my web .yaml file, and there are some pods which are also getting created. So the Arc web is the pod which is basically the Flux pod I was referring to. So Flux, which operator which will be continuously monitoring my GitHub repo, and the web which you're looking over here is the web pod which is running our application. So if I quickly show you the details of whatever is deployed, I'll run a quick command on the namespace level. I'll just run a deployment command on the namespace level. Okay. So if I run the same command, so you should be able to see a couple of things. So as you can see over here, we have an Arc web and web. So Arc web is basically our Flux pod, and then which is monitoring our GitHub repo, and this is our web application which we have deployed. Now just coming back to our web application, as you can see, it's coming from Khanasifan Azure Arc K8s web. So that's basically coming from our Docker Hub repository, Khanasifan Azure Arc K8s web, which I've already deployed as a RC1 version. So if I get back to my pods, so all looks pretty good. Now, if I just want to check basically the application which has been deployed, so I can say okay, get svc. So I have a cluster IP. If I copy the cluster IP, so once I have the cluster, I have a service IP. So this is the service under which our pod is communicating. I'll come back to our. So what I've also done is I have created a server in the same network so that I can access the pod's services directly. So if I just use my service IP address over here in this server, which is on the same network as the worker node. So if I run this, so it basically shows the same application experience, which is what we saw when we ran it through the web, through the Visual Studio. Now coming back to our configuration. So what we need to see next is the interesting bit is, like, let's say if we make any changes to our YAML configuration file, that should automatically get reflected in the cluster itself if the entire theory of Flux monitoring the Git config and whatnot is valid. So at this stage, if you look at the browser, this is our YAML configuration. At this stage, it's running one replica, and I have this is my RC1 image, and that's the message which is coming over here. Now coming back to my code, so what I'll do is I'll just update the message. So now I have version 1, and I'll also change the number of replicas. So I've made five replicas and my message has changed to v1 instead of v0. So if we go back into the server, we have v0, but now we should see v1. And there is something else which I'll do as well on the server, which is I'll initiate auto refresh. So that's an extension which I have installed. This basically auto refreshes at the interval which you will be providing. So that's, yeah, so that's it. And just I'll refresh the browser so that the extension changes get reflected. So yeah, so it's refreshing. As you can see, the number is changing. And in the background, what I'll also do is I'll just keep the terminal in this segment, in this window, because once we check in the code, all the changes happen pretty quick. So yeah, if we have it close to the application, it will be easy to monitor. So yeah, so I'll quickly just change that and coming back. Okay, so what I'll do is I'll just check in the code which I have just updated. So if I go back into my version control and if I'll say updated git YAML config, and this I'll push the changes. So all the changes are gone, and now if I push, so that is basically updating the changes in my GitHub repo, and quickly those all changes will start to reflect over here. So as you can see, there are already 19 refreshes happened. I have one arc KTS org pod, which is the web. Now you can see the changes are coming in, and now I have five different pods. And the other thing is the existing pod, which was already running, is now getting terminated. So yeah, so basically, yes, all the pods are getting initiated, and at the same time the old pod is getting decommissioned. So yeah, if I refresh this, so yeah, the version v1 has changed. The thing is that the machine is pretty slow, that's why it's not, didn't reflect that quick. But yeah, if you are running locally, I think you'll have, you can see the experience where this will toggle v0 to v1. The reason why that will happen is because when the decommissioning process is happening, it would basically sometime connect to the old pod, and then that would show the old message value. And if and when it connects to the new pod, it will provide the new value. So that toggle happens, which obviously didn't happen over here because I think so the machine is not that quick. But at the end of the day, we have the new message now. We have five different pods for our application running. And yeah, so the GitOps experience which we have tried to get is obviously enabled. Now if I go back and if I just say, okay, change it back to one, and that's it. So once I go and update my git config, so okay, maybe I have not saved it. All right, so that's changes have been reflected in my git control. So I'm just checking in now. So yeah, it's locally checked in. I'll push the changes. And once I do that, hopefully everything should start to come back. So if I go back to my terminal, so as soon as the check-in completes, we'll start to see the termination messages. Yeah, so you can see now the terminating messages have turned up, and we have got all the pods terminated apart from one pod which is still serving our application at this stage. So that's yeah, so it's already responding to all the requests which are coming in. I'll just turn this off because yeah, it eats a lot of memory on the machine. So as you can see, we have this this pod, which is our web pod. It's still running. So the configuration is pretty easy. Any changes you want to do. So if you want to make changes to your version of your image, if you want to make changes to your messages or anything, environment variables, all that is pretty streamlined, seamless. The difference is when you look at it from the perspective of DevOps, if you had to do the similar thing, it was a full build process, then there would be a release process, and that would be a lengthy activity. In this, it's just a change in the config, and then that automatically reflects into your Kubernetes cluster. So the experience is pretty smooth, basically this is not something specific for Azure Arc. It's an industry standard now. Most of the GitOps, most of the organizations are now using GitOps pretty in anger. So it's not something which is not tested or anything like that. I would highly recommend the teams to use GitOps with Azure Arc enabled Kubernetes. It's a very good experience, and definitely you can use it for a wide range, whatever way you are using Kubernetes. You can enable Arc on top of it, and then you can have this GitOps experience on top of it, so that will make things perfect. So yeah, thanks a lot for watching this session, and hopefully this session was of some value. Thanks a lot. Take care.